Hello students, how are you? What about your current situation? Hope you are staying home because the situation is going day by day. So please stay home and be safe. Today's class on chapter 4, you know that. Because yesterday I just started the chapter and also finished some issues. So this is the rest of the chapter. The chapter's name is business based on ownership. Okay, business based on ownership means depends on the number of owner, type of owners. The business can be categorized in many types. There are five types of business. First one is sole proprietorship business, and second one is partnership business. Sole proprietorship business, yesterday I told you and discussed it. The business where the business which is operated, which is formed, operated and controlled by a single person, then it is called the sole proprietorship business. That means owner is one person. The one person will be the owner. No other can share the losses, profits, liabilities, and no one can share it. So owner is one person, and this is called sole proprietorship business. And the size of sole proprietorship business is very much small. Capital is less capital needed, and also there is no legal complications to form the sole proprietorship business. But if you are staying in the city corporation, urban area, then you have to collect trade license from the city corporation office. So basically this is the main theme of sole proprietorship business. Now I'm going to discuss the another type of business, which is called partnership business. Describe it little in yesterday class, but I'm gonna discuss it elaborately today. So please be careful and just sit in front of your laptop with the textbook. It will be easy for you to understand. So what is partnership business? Partnership business means according to the Partnership Act 1932, where two or more than two people, two or more than two people form or control or operate a business is called a partnership business. And the main theme, main basis of partnership business is agreement. Agreement with the with agreement, you can two or more than two people can form the partnership business. And partnership business, in partnership business, according to the 1932 Act, partnership business, the agreement is must. Without any agreement, the partnership business cannot be, no business cannot be called as partnership business. So agreement is must. And according to 1932 Act, more than one individual means in 2 or 20%, maximum 20%, minimum 2, maximum 20, in case of ordinary partnership business. But banking partnership business, minimum partner is 2 and maximum partner is 10. That means ordinary partnership business, number of members are 2 to 20, and in banking sector it is 2 to 10. So this is the main character, main information about partnership business. Okay, and who are forming the partnership business? That means the member of partnership business are called partner. Okay, partner, that means partners. And the agreement is called the agreement is in written form, then it is called as deed. Okay, now formation of partnership business. How can you form the partnership business? There is partnership business, one type of business with a relationship between individuals based on agreement, where the business is operated by all or by one on behalf of all. That means it is very much easy to understand the business which is based on agreement, where owner two or more than two people can form the business, and in case of direction or in case of operation, one partner can operate on behalf of other person, on behalf of all. All partner can involved in direction or operation, or one person on behalf of all can control the business. It is depend on the agreement, but this thing should be, this type of things should be written on the agreement. But written on agreement, here I am saying that these things should be written on agreement, but there is a loophole. Loophole, that means in according to 1932 Act, there are no bindness to write the agreement. Agreement can be oral or written in both form, but if you are very much smart, and then you you will obviously written down it as a deed, because oral agreement cannot be the solid basis of the business. Oral people, as a human being, we are not very much trustworthy in all sector. So in future, if you want to avoid quarrels, want to avoid all the clashes, other financial complications, then you have to you have to take the agreement as a written form. So this is the thing. Okay, now formation of business. In formation of business, formation of partnership business is very easy, like sole proprietorship business. There is no legal complexity, and two eligible persons entering into contract can start the business. That means two eligible persons, that means maybe it is upper 18, above the 18 years, 18 or 18, above the 18 years. But there is no hard and fast rule that the agreement is to be written. That means there are no bindness or no hardness to that agreement is to be written. The existing partnership law of 1932 in Bangladesh did not make agreement and registration mandatory. That means registration of business and written agreement is not mandatory for the partnership business according to the 1932 Act. But you want to the agreement can be oral, but if you want to avoid legal procedures, contradiction, quarrels, mistrust, unreliability, this type of issue, you want to obviously want to avoid. So in this case, you have to written down the agreement, and also you should register the business. So this is not according to the Act, and this is not mandatory. For this reason, the agreement is treated as the main basis of partnership. Okay, it is the important MCQ question. What is the main basis of partnership business? The answer is agreement. Maybe it can be this question can be come for 1 mark or 2 marks also. For 2 marks, the question can be like, why agreement is the main basis of partnership business? Why it is? Cause you should say that, cause agreement is the main basis of business, cause this is all the things related to the all the information related to the business are written down in the agreement. And according to the Act, the business is formed, operated, and controlled by agreement also. So this year, that's why you can call that agreement is the main basis of partnership business. It is necessary to collect a trade license from city corporation or municipality to start a partnership business within existing rules of our country. Okay. This is done of formation of partnership business. Now the characteristics of partnership business. Characteristics, that means, so what are the characteristics? You can guess it easily. Formation of a partnership business is very easy since there is no legal complexity. Formation of partnership business is very easy since there is no legal complexity. That means there are less legal complications. The agreement between the partners works as the basis for the partnership business. Already told you, the agreement is the main basis for partnership business, and it is the business is formed, operated, and controlled according to the agreement. So, but agreement should be agreement maybe oral or written, maybe in any form, or a business can be registered or unregistered also. So this is the second characteristics. Now third, the partners in the business supply their fund according to the agreement. According to the agreement, the partners in the business supply their fund according to the agreement. Profit of business is also distributed according to the agreement. That means the amount of capital, the amount of profit, everything should be mentioned in the agreement, and it will be according to the agreement. This amount of capital, this amount of profit distribution or loss distribution, these are all things, all the things are maintained by the agreement, and it will be mentioned, it will be mentioned, or it is it will be must mention in the agreement. So this is the third point. And fourth, the business is formed on the basis of reliability and trust. Okay, reliability in partnership business, main theme are reliability and trust. Without reliability, without trust, you cannot form the partnership business, and the success of the partnership business mainly depends on this trust. So if any mistrust happens, the partnership business can be dissolved or dissolved. So trust and reliability is the another main basis of partnership business. Okay, now five, registration of partnership firm is not mandatory, but the registered company enjoys some facility over the unregistered company. That means registered companies face several benefits that unregistered company doesn't enjoy it. So if you get the legal help while you facing the financial problems or financial complexities, or maybe quarrels or contradiction among the partners or the with the third parties, then you can get the legal help if the business is registered. So registration is logical for partnership business but not mandatory. Okay, now deed of partnership business. Deed, what is deed? Deed means the when the agreement is in written form, it is called as deed. Written agreement is called as deed, partnership deed. So this is deed of partnership business. Partnership business is formed with an agreement between two or more people. The agreement can be oral or the agreement can be written and registered. It is mandatory have an agreement to start a partnership business, but written, it doesn't matter whether agreement is oral, written, registered or unregistered, but agreement, the existence of agreement is must. Whether it can be written, whether it can be oral, maybe registered or unregistered, so doesn't matter, but it should be present. Agreement should be present in the partnership business. For this reason, agreement is treated as the main basis for partnership business. As per statement from Partnership Act 1932, partnership relation is built from agreement, not from status. So partnership relation is built from where it is from where from the agreement. Partnership relation is built from agreement but not from status. Written agreement is called as partnership deed. Partnership deed is such evidence that describes the objective of the business, operational guideline, position of each partner, responsibilities, activities, and right and specific method to solve potential problem in future. The agreement is to be signed by all partners. This is to be kept in mind that business conducted to make and distribute profit shall not be considered as partnership business if there is no such agreement. If the children of a deceased person become the heir and the operate the business, share the profit among them, then it will not be a partnership business since there is no agreement with the children. Okay, that means in partnership business, the main theme of this para that the agreement is why it is called that agreement is the main basis of partnership business. For me, agreement is main basis because of all the information related to the business, like operational guideline, position of each partner, responsibility, liabilities, profit distribution, activities and right specific method to solve potential problem. Everything should be written in the agreement, and everything should be present in the agreement. So that's why you can say that agreement is the main basis of partnership business, and this agreement is must be signed by all partners, and this is to be kept in mind that business conducted to make and distribute profit shall not be considered a partnership business. That means if you form a business with all the characteristics which is related to the business, which is present in the business, all the characteristics of business is present, but you cannot say that this is partnership business until you are making the agreement. So this is the main theme. Okay, contents of the deed of partnership business. Contents of the deed of partnership business is which information are written down in the deed, should be written down in the deed. This is the list of those information. Which issues are stated in the deed of agreement? So these are the issues. It should be written down in the deed of agreement. First one is name and address of the partnership business, nature, objective and scope of business, expiration or validity of the business, name, address and position of the partners, total capital of the firm, capital to be paid by each partner and payment method, rules to run the business, introduction of the partners who will directly run the business, profit and loss distribution method, responsibilities, power and rights of partners, name of the bank, address and nature of account to be opened, name of the partners who are operating the bank account, guideline to include new partner and exclusion of existing partner, estimation, reservation and payment method for sharing case of death of a partner, retirement and dismissal process of partners, solution method for future contradiction, and method of dissolution of partnership business. So these issues must be stated in the deed of agreement. So this is these things are the important issues for partnership business, or main, you can say that this is the main theme of partnership business. Method of dissolution. Dissolution means it can be said in Bengali below, or you can say this means the expiry of the business or end of the business. Dissolution means the end of the business. So method of dissolution of partnership is the last issue of the deed of agreement. Now registration of partnership business. Registration of partnership business refers to the enlistment of the name of the company with the government appointed office of the registrar. That means your business should be enlisted in the list of the government operated office. So government appointed office or registrar. Of the register. So this is the registration this is called the registration of partnership business. Registration of partnership business means enlistment of the name of company with the government appointed office of the registrar. When you want to register it, but the registration of the partnership business is not mandatory according to the Partnership Act 1932. But if you register your companies, you will enjoy some several benefits which are not enjoying the unregistered business. So you want to register it, you will submit the application to the registrar with all the information here: name of the partnership business, address of the head office, address of the branches, objective of the business, date of business, expiry or validity of the business, a partner's name, address and profession, and date of joining as a partner in the business. So these are the informations of which you will have to submit when you fill up the application form to the registrar. This is the registration. After checking all the information and all the papers related to the application form, if the registrar is satisfied, then he will enlist your company name in the list, and the registrar will inform you in writing. So after that, the registration process will be end. So this is the registration of partnership business. Your homework should homework will be what is partnership business. You have to do your homework regularly, and obviously you have to do it. So your homework is listen carefully. What is partnership business? What are the characteristics of partnership business? What do you mean by deed of partnership business? And what are the contents of the deed of partnership business? And registration, and last of all, the registration of partnership business. That means which topics I'll be discussing today, they're all gonna be your homework. But the question is, what is partnership business? What are the main characteristics of partnership business? What do you mean by deed of agreement, and what are the contents of deed of agreement? And the last one is registration. What is the explain the registration of partnership business. So these are the homework for your next class. I'll talk to you in next class. Till then, bye bye.